Hello and welcome to my today's session. In today's session, we will discuss involute and cycloid. How to draw involute and cycloid in different methods we will discuss in this session. And before drawing involute and cycloid, we will define involute and what is cycloid. In our previous session, we have discussed how to draw tangent and normal to the conic sections like ellipse, parabola, and hyperbola we have discussed in our last session. Now let me move further to define what is involute and cycloid. So in this session, we will see the involute and cycloid, and spiral and helix we will discuss in next session. In this session, we have different methods to, and we have different, configurations to draw involute. One is involute, we have different cases to draw involute. One is involute of a circle when the string length is equal to perimeter, when the string length is more than the perimeter, when the string length is less than the perimeter. So we will look into this, these three types. These three methods to draw involute. Then we will see the composite shapes. That means instead of having circular shape, it can also be a square, it can also be a hexagon, or it can be a composite type of hexagon. Some portion is hexagon and some portion is circular. Those we will see. Then we move forward to see to draw the cycloid. So cycloid, we will draw general method. Then we will see the trochoid, superior type, trochoid inferior. Then we will move forward to see epicycloid and hypocycloid in this session. In the next session, we will see the spiral and helix. Now let us see how to draw and what are the definitions of involute and cycloid. Cycloid is a locus of a point on the periphery of a circle, which if it rolls on a straight line path. That means whenever a point on the circumference of the circle, if the path traced by that point, if that circle rolls on a straight line path. In turn, you can also define the path traced by a point on the circumference of the circle when the circle rolls in a straight line path. So that is called the cycloid. The path traced by a point when the circle rolls on a straight line path is called cycloid. Now the involute is vice versa to cycloid. The path traced by a point on a straight line when the straight line rolls on the circumference of the circle is called the involute. In other words, it is a locus of a free end of a string when it is wound around a circular pole. In this way also you can define. So the path traced by a point on a string when it is wound around a circular pole is nothing but involute. The spiral and helix we will define in this session itself, but the drawings we will see the in the next session. Spiral is a curve. Basically, spiral is a curve generated by a point which revolves around a fixed point, and it moves towards the fixed point. It's called a spiral. Basically, spiral is a curve generated by a point which revolves around a fixed point, and at the same time it moves towards that point is called the spiral. Then helix is a curve generated by a point which moves around the circumference of a right circular cylinder or a cone. At the same time it advances in axial direction. The path traced by a point on the circumference of the circle, and at the same time if it moves along the axis of the cylinder or the cone, is nothing but helix. These four types are very, very important to draw And this involute and cycloidal profiles are used in the case of gear profiles, gear teeth profiles. The gear teeth profiles are may be cycloidal or involute. The profile of the teeth can be cycloidal or involute. Now let us see the cycloid and involute drawings. The cycloid can be superior tripod or inferior tripod, epicycloid and hypocycloid. We will see what are these in the next slide. Then let us take one problem in involute. To draw the involute of a circle, draw involute of a circle, string length is equal to the circumference of the circle. That means this circle is going to roll on the string or on a straight line up to the distance which is equal to the circumference of the circle. So take a circle, draw a circle with a given diameter. Then divide this circle into convenient number of equal divisions. Say in this case, I'm dividing this circle into 8 equal divisions like this. 8 equal divisions. Then calculate the circumference. Then draw a horizontal line from the end point 8 in this case. So that is equal to pi d. Draw a horizontal line. So the horizontal line length is equal to the perimeter, that is equal to pi d. So that is at the bottom of the circle like this. Then draw the perpendiculars. Then divide this perimeter into the 8 equal number divisions, or the number of divisions that we have done on the circle. So on the circle, so this circle we are divided into 8 equal divisions. So the same number of divisions that we have to do on this perimeter. So same 8 divisions. If we divide this circle into 12 equal divisions, then this perimeter should also be divided into 12 equal divisions. Then if the circle is divided into 4 equal divisions, then we have to divide this perimeter into 4 equal divisions. If we increase the number of divisions, we will get the smooth curve. We will get the more number of points to connect or to generate the curve. So it is preferably required to divide the circle into the convenient number of divisions. So in this case, I am dividing the circle into 8 equal divisions. And the same 8 number of equal divisions, I am dividing the perimeter. So 8 equal divisions like this. In this case, the perimeter is equal to the string length. So exactly this circle is going to roll on the perimeter length like this. And similarly, and mark all those points, then draw the perpendicular lines from the divided circle lines like this. Draw the perpendicular lines at 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and up to 8. 8 itself indicates the horizontal line like this. Then take 0,8 as radius or 1,8 as radius. Take 1,8 as radius. Take 1,8 as radius in compass with 1 as center. Intersect this line. So you will get a point P1. That means with 1P as radius, with 1 as a center, you intersect this perpendicular line at one point, at point 1. So you will get P1. Then take 2P as radius with 2 as center, intersect this vertical line to get P2. And similarly, 3P as radius with 3 as center, intersect the perpendicular line at point 3, you will get P3 point. So repeat this step for all the remaining lines. So after getting all these 8 points, then join all these points to get a smooth curve of involute of a circle. Join all these points as a smooth curve using French curves. You will get a smooth curve. This curve is called involute of a circle. I repeat these steps once again. I repeat all the steps to draw involute once again. Draw the involute of a circle string. String length is equal to the circumference of the circle. So first step is to draw the circle with a given diameter. Then divide this circle into convenient equal number of divisions like this. In this case, I am dividing circle into 8 equal divisions. Then calculate the perimeter or the circumference. Calculate the length of the circumference of this circle. Then draw a horizontal line from the bottom point of the circle like this. Then divide this circumference into the number of divisions that we have done in the case of circle. Same number of divisions. In a circle, we are divided into 8 equal divisions. So that we have to divide this circumference line into same number of divisions, that is 8. Divide this pi d into 8 equal divisions and name all those points from 1 to 8 like this. Then draw the perpendicular lines on the circular points like this. At point 1, draw the perpendicular line, and at 2, 3, and repeat this up to the 8 points on the circle. Then take 1P as radius, 1P as radius, 1 as center. Intersect this perpendicular line at point 1. You will get P1 point. Then 2P as radius with 2 as center. Then intersect the perpendicular line at point 2 on the circumference of the circle. Then 3P as radius with 3 as center on the circumference of the circle. And intersect this line to get P3 point. Repeat this step for the remaining perpendicular lines on the circumference of the circle to get the remaining points. Then join all these points as a smooth curve to get the involute of the circle like this. This procedure is very, very important and to draw the involute of different sizes of the circles and different lengths of the perimeters. Now let us draw an involute of a circle. String length is more than the circumference of the circle. But in the previous case, we have drawn the involute of a circle that is equal to, the string length is equal to the perimeter. But now we are going to draw the involute of a circle. The string length is more than the circumference of the circle like this. Now divide the circle into convenient number of equal divisions like this, say in this case also 8. Name all those points from 1 to 8. Now draw a horizontal line from the bottom point, the last point of the circle on the circumference of the circle, that is 8. From this point, I draw a horizontal line. The length of this horizontal line is more than the circumference of the circle, that is pi d. Now exactly pi d is coming less than the horizontal line like this. Then divide this line into 8 equal divisions like this. Same number of divisions that we have done on the circumference of the circle like this. So divide this into 8 equal divisions. Then draw the perpendicular lines on the circumference of the circle. The points from the points on the circumference of the circle like this. At 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 like this. Then take 1P as radius with 1 as center. Intersect this point 1 or the perpendicular line on the circumference of the circle to get point P1. And similarly, 2P as radius with 2 as center, get the point P2. then 3P as radius with P as center, get the point P3, and repeat this until for the eighth point on the circumference of the circle. Join all those points to get a smooth curve, which is an involute of a circle, but in this case the circumference of the circle is more than the perimeter. Now let us draw involute of a circle. String length is less than the circumference of the circle. In the previous case we have seen the circumference or the horizontal line or the string length is more than the circumference, but now the circumference is less than the perimeter. Now let us see. Draw a circle with a given diameter, then divide the circle into convenient equal number of divisions, then name all those points. In this case we have divided the circle into 8 equal divisions, so that we have to name from 1 to 8. Then draw a horizontal line from the last point or the last division on the circumference of the circle. Then indicate the circumference on the horizontal line pi d, but the string length is more than the pi d. String length pi d. Okay, so but this here the string length is less than the pi d, but here the string length is less than the circumference pi d value, as you can observe in this figure. Divide this line into same number of divisions that we have done in the case of circle. Now divide this line into 8 equal divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. But here the string length is less than the circumference. So now name all those points. Take 1P as radius, take 1P as radius with 1 as center, then get the point. So now draw the perpendicular lines like we did in our previous examples. Now in this case you take 1P as radius, then with 1 as center, get P1 point by intersecting this perpendicular line on the point which is on the circumference of the circle. Then take 2P as radius with 2 as center, get P2 point, then P3, P4, P5, P6, and up to 8, repeat this step. Then join all those points as a smooth curve. We will get a curve that is called involute, but in this case the circumference is less than, the string length is less than the circumference. That means the circle is rolling, I mean this string is moving or wounding on this circle with a short length. That means the string that we are going to wound on this circle is less than the circumference of the circle. That's all. Now let us see involute of composite shape. Now you see, let us take a problem. I read out the problem. A pole is of a shape of half hexagon, as you can see in this case. Then A string is to be wound having a length equal to the pole perimeter. So this string needs to be wound on this composite figure. The string length is equal to the perimeter of this composite figure. Okay, then draw the path of the free end P of the string when wound completely. Now we have to trace, or we have to draw the locus of the point which is at the end of this string. Now let us draw a horizontal line to this figure. This is already given in our problem. So the horizontal line length is equal to the perimeter of this composite figure. Now calculate pi d by 2 first, then you add the length of this length of the side of the hexagon. Now is given, take hexagon 30 mm side, M semicircle of 60 mm diameter. Now the length of this string is pi d by 2. The semicircle portion is pi d by 2. And the length of these three hexagonal sides, each side is 30 mm. So 30 mm plus 30 mm plus 30 plus pi d by 2 is the total length of the string. With that length, draw a horizontal line. Okay. Then divide the circle into four equal divisions. So the upper half of the circle is in our previous case, we have divided the circle into 8 equal divisions. Now we have a semicircle here. So divide this semicircle into four equal divisions. So then indicate those points 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And similarly indicate the hexagonal points also 6. Then the same number of divisions. Here you can see here. The first length is this. The first length is side. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is circle. And from here to from this point is the perimeter of the half of the circle. Then we have the first line. This is A1 length. Then perimeter up to here. Then 5, 6 length is this one. Then 6A length is this one. So totally three sides of the hexagon and pi d by 2 will be the length. Now you can see these are the three. So first length, second, third length of the hexagon. Then pi d by 2 will be the half of the semicircle perimeter like this. Then draw the name all those points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then draw a tangent at A1, draw a tangent at A1, draw a tangent at 1, draw a tangent to A1 line, and at point 1, draw a perpendicular line, at point 2, draw a perpendicular line, 3, 4, 5, and draw a tangent at 6, like this, and similarly. Now I come back here, then take 1P, take AP as radius, take AP as radius with A as center, get point P. Okay. Then 1P as radius with 1 as center, get point P1. Then 2P as radius, with 2 as center, get point P2. Then 4P as radius, with 4 as center, get point 4. Like this and repeat until for all the points. So the first step is draw a tangent to at point A along the side of the hexagon. Then draw a perpendicular line at point 1, which is specific to the semicircle point 1. Then similarly, draw the perpendicular lines from 2, 3, 4, 5 respectively. Then draw a tangent to the side of the hexagon like this. Then after drawing the lines, take AP as radius with A as center, get point P. 1P as radius, 1 as center, get point P1. With 2P as radius, with 2 as center, get point P2. With 3P as radius, with 3 as center, get point P3. And repeat this to get all the points. Then join all those points. Join all those points like this as a smooth curve using the French curves to get a curve for the composite shape of involute for the composite shape. In this case, we have a semicircle and we have a half hexagon combined together. For this, we have drawn the involute. That means a string is wound. The string length is equal to the perimeter of this figure and which is wound on the circumference of this composite figure. Then we have drawn the path traced by the end point of this string. When we wound that string on the circumference of this composite figure. So this is what the path traced by the P. When we wound the string on the circumference of this composite figure like this. So when we wound this string, which is equal to the length of the circumference of this composite figure, this point P is going to follow this path like this. I repeat this once again, these steps. So exactly the problem intention is to draw a involute of a composite shaped figure. In this case, I repeat this once again. The aim of this problem is to draw the involute of composite shaped figure. A pole is a shape of half hexagon. A pole is a shape of half hexagon and semicircle. It is having semicircle and half hexagon. For that figure, we need to draw the involute. That means involute is nothing but the path traced by a point on the string when it is wound on a shape. If it is on the circle, that is called the involute of a circle. If it is a hexagon, that is called involute of hexagon. Now, in this case, it is a composite shape. It is having hexagon and half semicircle. A string is to be wound having length equal to the pole perimeter or the composite shaped perimeter. Draw the path of free end P, that means where to draw the locus of this point P, which is at the end of the string, when we wound completely. This is what the problem. Then the side of the hexagon is 30 mm and the semicircle diameter is 60 mm. First, let us draw the figure. Let us draw the figure. So half circle, semicircle, then half hexagon like this of side 30. After drawing this, draw a horizontal line, which is equal to the length of the perimeter. So the length of this horizontal line equal to the perimeter of this composite figure. The perimeter of this composite figure includes the perimeter of half circle and perimeter of half hexagon. So by adding these two perimeters, we have to calculate the length of the perimeter. So 30, 30, 30, 90 plus pi d by 2, where d is 60, will give you the perimeter or the length of this horizontal line. Perimeter or length of the horizontal line. Name those points as AP. Then divide the upper half circle into four equal divisions like this. In our previous case, we have divided the circle into equal divisions, 8 equal divisions. But now it is a semicircle, so I am dividing this into 4 equal divisions. Then name the points as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And similarly, hexagon also. Name the point 6. Then locate the points. Locate the points similar to that of the perimeter points like this. The first line A1 length, so A1 up to this here, A1 length up to here it is 30. Then from 1 to 5 is the perimeter of the semicircle. Then we have to divide this semicircular length into 4 equal divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4 equal divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4 equal divisions. Pi d by 2 needs to be divided into 4 equal divisions. Then we have 5-6 length. This is 5-6 length. Then 6A length is from here to P, like this. Then name all those points like this. Like this. Then draw a tangent from point A. like this. Draw a vertical line or a perpendicular line from point A and from 2, 3, 4, 5, and similarly draw a tangent at 6 also. Then take AP as radius with A as center, get point P. Intersect this tangent at location and you will get some intersection point. That point is P. Then take 1P as radius with 1 as center, intersect the vertical line to get point P1. Then 2P as radius with 2 as center, get point P2. With the 3 as center, get point P3. And similarly, get all those points, join all the curves to get a smooth curve of composite shaped figure of semicircle and half hexagon like this. Now let me move forward to see one more problem. I read out the problem. A rod AB, 85 mm long, rolls over a semicircular pole without slipping. A rod AB of length rolls over a semicircular pole without slipping from its initial vertical position to till it becomes upside down vertical. Draw locus of both the points. That means from the bottom point, we need to draw the locus of the bottom point and as well as the top point of the line. When the vertical line of length 85 mm until it becomes upside down and downside up, we have to draw the locus of the point A that is at the top of this line and the other point at the bottom of the line like this. Now this is our vertical line AB. This is the length of this vertical line is 85. Then we have a semicircle. The semicircle radius is not given. Conveniently, assume the semicircle radius, some radius. For that radius, I draw a semicircle. And on this semicircle, this vertical pole needs to be rolled on the circumference of this semicircle until this point B should come down and A point should come up vertically, upside down and downside up, until to become upside down and downside up. This vertical line needs to be rolled on the semicircle. To draw the to draw the locus of point A and B of the vertical line until it becomes upside down and downside up, then divide and get the pi d. We are assumed we have drawn one circle here with so and so diameter or so and so radius, and calculate the circumference of this circle pi d and mark the length of the circumference of the circle on the vertical line. Then name those points as 1, 2, 3, 4, or divide this circumference into convenient equal number of divisions. Say in this case, I am dividing this semicircle, I mean circumference of this circle, into 4 equal divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then divide the circle also into 4 equal divisions. Like this, name the points as 1, 2, 3, 4. Then locate the points on this. Then draw a perpendicular line at point 1 and at point 2, at point 3 on the circumference of the circle, then at the point 4, like this. Drawing the perpendicular lines at the points of the at the points on the circumference of the circle, then you take A1 B1, okay, then A2 B2, then A3 B3, A4 B4. Now before that I will tell you, with you take you take A B as radius, okay, and with A with one as center, okay, then A2 B2, A3 B3, A4 B4 like this, then draw the circle like this. That means from A to B, take A to B, okay, then one as center, then you get B1 point, okay. Otherwise, 1B as center, you take, I repeat this once again, draw the vertical lines on the circumference of the circle at 1, 2, 3, 4 points, then take 1B as radius, take 1B as radius with 1 as center, get the point B1. Then 2B as radius with 2 as center, get the point B2. Then 3B as radius, then get the point B3. Okay. Then 4B as radius with 4 as a center, get the point B4 and A4 like this. After getting all those points, join all the curves, join all the points. So B, B1, B2, and B3. Okay. So then join A1, A2, A3, and A4 like this. And similarly, you get, I repeat this once again, draw a vertical line that is equal to, draw a vertical line that is equal to 85 mm length, then draw a semicircle with the assumed diameter or the radius, then divide this perimeter and mark the perimeter of this circle on the vertical line and divide this into 4 equal divisions or convenient equal divisions. Those number of divisions we have to do on the semicircle also. Say in this case, I am dividing the perimeter into 4 equal divisions, then divide the circle also into 4 equal divisions like this. Then name all those points as 1, 2, 3, 4. Then draw the perpendicular lines from the circumference points like this at point 1, at point 2, at point 3, at point 4 like this. Then take A4 or A1 as radius, with A1 as radius, with 1 as center, you get A1 point. Okay. Then B1 as radius, with 1 as center, get B1 point. Then similarly, A2 as radius, 2 as a center, get A2 point. Then B2 as radius with 2 as center, get B2 point. Then similarly, A3 as radius, A3 as radius with 3 as center, A3 point you will get. Then B3 as radius with B3 as center, get B3 point. Then join B, B1, B2, B3. B, B1, B2, B3, and similarly, you join A1, A2, A3, A4, A1, A2, A3, A4 using the French curves. So this is the rod of 85 mm long rolls over a semicircular pole without slipping from its initial vertical position until it become bottom down and top up. This is called the involute. Now let us see the cycloid procedure also. Cycloid is nothing but the path traced by a point on the circumference of the circle when the circle rolls and a straight line without slipping is nothing but cycloid. I repeat this. Cycloid is a curve traced by a point on the circumference of the circle. When the circle rolls on a straight line without slipping is called cycloid. We have already defined this. Now take one problem. Draw a locus of a point on the periphery of a circle which rolls on a straight line path. Take circle diameter as 50 mm. Now the straight line path, draw a locus of a point on the periphery of a circle which rolls on a straight line path. Take circle diameter as 50 mm. Draw a circle first, then draw a horizontal line at the bottom. Now my intention is to draw this circle on this straight line. Divide this circle into equal number of divisions, convenient equal number of divisions. Say I am dividing this circle into 8 equal divisions. Name all those points from left to right like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, and up to here it is 8. 8 divisions. Then locate a point at the bottom. This is the point which is going to roll on this circumference of the circle, which is a straight line. Now we need to draw the locus of this point. Now this point is at the bottom of the circle. When it rolls on the straight line, we have to draw the locus of this point. That is called the cycloid. So after dividing this into 8 equal divisions, then draw a horizontal line at the center also like this. Then similarly calculate pi d. Calculate pi d circumference. Then divide the center line into equal number of divisions that we have done in the case of circle. Same number of equal divisions. So 8 equal divisions we have to do. Yes. Similarly, because the circle is divided into 8 equal divisions, same number of divisions we have to do from the center of the circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 8 equal divisions we have done. The perimeter also. Circumference also. Then name all those points as C1 to C8. These are the centers. These are the points we are going to use as the centers to draw the cycloid. Then take radius of this circle in our compass with C1 as center. So before drawing that, so draw the horizontal lines from 4, 3, 5 and 1, 7. So from the 1, 7 line, 1, 7 points on the circumference of the circle, draw a horizontal line, and similarly from 3 to 5 and from the 4 also. After drawing the horizontal lines from the points on the circumference of the circle, take radius in our compass. Radius of the circle of the compass with C1 as center. Then intersect first line like this. So by taking radius of the circle in our compass with C1 as center, intersect 1 and 7 with C1 as center and 7 as center like this. 7 as center. So the same line will be intersected at this location. And similarly, same radius in our compass with C3 as center, intersect 3 and 5 line with 4 as center and get the point on the horizontal line at this location. Similarly, 5th line, then 6th also, 7th and 8th like this. 6th we will get at this location itself. Then join all those points, locate the points. This is our first point and this is our second point with C2 as center, and intersect this second line at this location. Then with C3 as center, third point we will get at this location, fourth, then fifth, and sixth we will get at this location with radius with C6 as center. We will get a point at this location. And 8th point exactly we will get at this point. Then join all those points like this as a smooth curve. Indicate those points as P4, P5, P6, P7, P7 and P8, join all those points as a smooth curve using the French curve to get a cycloid like this. This is called the cycloid of the circle. The path traced by a point on the circumference of the circle when it rolls on a straight line without slipping is called cycloid. Now we have drawn the path traced by a point P on the circumference of the circle when the circle rolls on a straight line without slipping. I repeat this cycloid procedure once again. Draw a circle with a given diameter. In this case, the circle diameter is 50. Then divide the circle into 8 equal divisions, or the convenient equal divisions. Say in this case, I'm dividing the circle into 8 equal divisions like this. Then name all those points from left side to right side, from 1, 2, 3, and up to 7, and finally you will get the final point at 8 here at the bottom of the circle. I am assuming a point at the bottom of the circle now. So to this point, I want to draw the path of this circle when the circle rolls on this straight line without slipping. Now, draw a horizontal line at the center. The length of this line is equal to the circumference of the circle, that is equal to pi d. Then divide this circumference line into 8 equal divisions. Why 8 means? Because we have already divided the circle into 8 equal divisions. If the circle is divided into 12 equal divisions, then we have to divide the circle or this horizontal line also into 8 equal divisions, 12 equal divisions. In this case, I have divided the circle into 8 equal divisions, so that I am dividing this circumference into 8 equal divisions. Then after dividing this circumference into 8 equal divisions, so name all those points into as C1, C2 to C8 like this. Then draw the horizontal lines from the points on the circumference of the circle like this. We have 3, 5, 1, 7 on the circumference of the circle. From those points, draw the horizontal lines. Then draw the horizontal line from the fourth point also. Then take radius of the circle in our compass with C1 as center. Get the points on one line 1, and similarly take point with 7 as center, intersect the point at this location. Otherwise take C2 as center, then get the point. C3 as center, get the point on the third line and as well as fifth line. And take C4 as center, get the point on the fourth, then fifth, 6, 7, 8, and locate the points also on this. This will become your P1, and this will become your P2, P3, and this is your fourth point, fifth point, and sixth you will get here, and seventh, and finally you will get 8th point here. Now join all those points to get a smooth curve. That curve is called cycloid. Now join all those points. Name all those points as P1 to P8 like this. Then join these points to get a smooth curve. So that curve is called the cycloid. Then I move forward to see the superior trochoid. So that means we will see what is superior trochoid. Draw a locus of a point 5 mm away from the periphery of A, periphery of a circle which rolls on a straight line path. Now, the intention of the problem is to draw the trochoid or the locus of a point 5 mm away from the periphery of the circle. In the previous case, we have seen exactly on the periphery of the circle, we have drawn the locus of that point. But now, the intention of this problem is to draw the locus of the assumed point on the circumference of the circle, which is away from the circumference of the circle. This is called superior trochoid. So take the circle diameter as 50, draw a circle with 50 mm diameter, draw a horizontal line and divide the circle and draw one more circle which is 5 mm excess to the radius of the previous circle. The original circle is 50 mm and add 10 mm diameter or 5 mm radius to this previous circle. Draw one more circle which is concentric to the first circle. Or draw a concentric circle to the first circle like this. So the radius of this circle is 5 mm more than the previous circle. After drawing the second circle, then divide these two circles, concentric circles, into 12 equal divisions. Then draw the horizontal lines. Name all those points as 1 to 8. Then draw the horizontal lines, which is equal to pi d, like we have done in the previous problem. Divide this circumference or the center line, center horizontal line, into 8 equal divisions like this. Then name all those points as C1 to C8, so which we are going to use as centers to locate the points. Then draw the horizontal lines like this from 1 to 7 and 2 to 6, 3 to 5 and from the 4 finally. Then take radius, that is 50, and C1 as center and get the line, get the point P1 here. Then with C3 as center, get the point at this location. Then C4 as center, get the point. Then C5 as center, get the point. But here the radius is the radius of the previous circle and plus 5 mm. So take, in this case it is 50 mm diameter, 25, and we are drawing the superior trochoid, that means 5 mm away from the previous circle or the circle of the generating circle, so that it is 25 plus 5 we need to consider. That means total radius that we need to take is 30 mm in this case. So take 30 mm radius and with C1 as center, get a point at the first line. With C2 as center, get one more point. With C3 as center, intersect the line, horizontal line, which is passing from 3 to 5. Then take C4 as center and intersect or get the point on the horizontal line that is passing from point 4. Then get the fifth point, take C5 as center, then intersect this third and fifth line and take C7 as center, get the intersection line, and C8 as center, get the intersection line. Then locate the points like this, locate the points, then join all those points. So name all those points. P2 will get at this location. So with C2 as center and get P2 point, 3 you will get, 4 you will get, C5, and similarly name all those points. Join all these points. You will get a smooth curve like this by using French curves. Join all those points. We will get a smooth curve. This is called superior trochoid. Similarly, I move forward to draw the inferior trochoid. That means in the previous problem, we have drawn the involute, which is above the circle now. Now, draw the locus of the point, draw the locus of the point, which is above the, which is below the generating circle like this. Now you take problem, draw a locus of a point, 5 mm inside the periphery of a circle, which rolls on a straight line path, take circle diameter as 50, then draw a circle here, then draw a circle which is less than the 50 mm diameter inside this circle. That means this circle should be concentric to the first circle. Then divide this into 8 equal divisions. Then draw the horizontal lines up to the circumference, up to the perimeter. So then, after locating the centers, draw the horizontal lines from the inferior circle, and from here take the radius. In this case, you see it is 50, the radius is 25, but now we have to subtract minus 5 from the 25 so that it is 20. So take 20 as radius with C1 as center, get the points C4, C5, C6 and C7. Get the points like this, join all those points to get a smooth curve like this. Locate the points. The difference is, in this case, the final radius to locate the points is, in this case, that value should be subtracted from the original diameter of the circle, or the generating circle is this. So the generating circle radius is 25 here. So we have to subtract 5 millimeters from 25. We will get 20 in this case. So with that 20 mm radius, and from C1 to C8 centers, get the points on the horizontal lines which are passing from the circle, located the points on the circumference of the circle. After getting the points, join all those points to get a smooth curve. So this is called the inferior circle, inferior trochoid. Okay, so thank you, one and all. So we will discuss in detail or some other generating curves, some other engineering curves in our next session. With this, I close the session here now.